Hello, this is Jatinder here. I'm doing a voiceover for the Restoration of Fractured Incisors case study. This case relates to a lady in her late 30s who attended my practice, requesting information about her options for her three upper fractured incisors. That's the upper central incisors and the upper right lateral incisor. These were fractured many years prior, and she wanted to know what she could have done to have the incisors built up and possibly some of the imbrication improved as well. Clinically, there weren't any symptoms and no signs of any pathology. It was just a straightforward enamel fracture. They were uncomplicated. And so we carried out some impressions and made some study models. The laboratory then created a 3D model that indicated the ideal tooth position and the correct tooth morphology. From that, we made a palatal putty stent and a thin acrylic blowdown. So at her appointment, we take a shade preoperatively, and it was shade B1, and we went for Luna 2 composite because it has excellent handling due to the filler composition. It doesn't slump, it's easy to handle, it's durable, and it produces excellent aesthetics. Because this was a simple incisal build-up, a single shade was actually appropriate, and it came out as shade B1. So this patient had previously had a bit of tooth whitening carried out, and the bleach shade was the correct shade for this patient. So we isolate the teeth using a generic rubber dam system, and we place the palatal putty representation of the teeth, and we can see the amount of buildup that we were required to make. So the teeth were built up one by one. So the slide shows the first tooth to be built up was the upper right central incisor, and we use the putty guide just to create a good palatal form, which I find is the easiest way for me to do this, and then just individually building up each tooth, and that helps to ensure there are good contacts and there isn't any joining of the composites. So the blowdown is used periodically during the procedure to make sure that the tooth morphology is being recreated as closely as possible. So this is a freehand technique, so we're just using the blowdown and the putty jig as a guide to help us along. So once we've built all three incisors, we carry out the polishing of the composites using our generic rubber polishing cup system, and then I usually finish off with a bristle brush. Once the composites are placed, we discharge the patient and we do a review at 2 weeks, and that's to double check the aesthetics are satisfactory and that the bonding has been successful. Building up incisors can be very challenging, and even though patients might have no history of parafunction, a debond is a risk. So looking at the patient again at 2 weeks, there were absolutely no problems and the contacts were rechecked and everything seemed satisfactory. There's also some dehydration during the procedure of the enamel, which can give you a bit of a shade discrepancy. And then doing a review at a couple of weeks later helps me to just verify good aesthetics. And we were all happy. So many thanks for listening. And that's a very brief case summary of an everyday case, a simple direct composite technique that most dentists would consider in general practice. Many thanks.